Hey, Ron. So listen, we've got this new name, Christopher A. Ray. I think there were some rumblings. I see the some reports saying that he was going to be interviewed, but he certainly wasn't somebody at the top of the list. Do you know anything about him, and are you surprised by this announcement?
Well, I think the timing of the announcement is interesting because so much focus has been given to Jim Comey's testimony tomorrow. I'm sure some commentators will see this as a grand distraction by the president to take some focus off of his past and dealings with Jim Comey. But Mr. Ray, I don't know him personally. I think his record is his record in government is far shorter than many of the other candidates that had been previously interviewed or spoken about. I understand he did a stint for about 2 years as an assistant attorney general, I think in charge of the criminal division. That goes back a decade or so.
Right.
Thought to be very bright and capable. Perhaps that limited record in public service, some will see as an asset because it would give senators who would be involved in the confirmation less of an opportunity to find areas where they differ with him and be able to criticize him and ultimately perhaps to vote against him. But, you know, my hope is that there's a strong consensus around this candidate. If this turns out to be the selection, I hope he's the right person for the job. I'll tell you, it's a big job. It's going to take someone who has a ton of energy and intellect and capacity to do it right.
Yeah, and I would think the desire to remain independent, you know, over the past few days, we've heard story after story alleging that the president of the White House has tried to influence some of these people in top intel positions. And that is ultimately what lawmakers and the public want to know when the former FBI director testifies tomorrow. I'm wondering, you know, you touched on the timing of this all, and certainly the hearings today and the hearings tomorrow are going to be must-watch TV. Are you surprised at all that we're getting this tweet this morning?
I'm not. I think that I'm a little bit surprised because we haven't heard in recent days of any other candidates going to the White House. And frankly, with the pace of leaks and, you know, whether they were deliberate or artful coming out of the White House, it seems like we had a pretty quick awareness of every candidate. And I think it's been interesting that we've heard nothing for the last week or so. And I think people took that as a sign. Well, some took it as a sign that the president was losing some confidence in Jeff Sessions, his attorney general.
Mm-hmm.
Or maybe that there was a scramble for other candidates that they had not heard about. And so it's interesting that this particular candidate has risen to the surface, even though the last week or so has been very, very quiet. Again, I wish him, you know, great success in taking on what could be the momentous challenge of his life, particularly in this administration.
Yeah, indeed. Ron Hosko, thank you so much for jumping into the fray so quickly. I want to bring in Paula Reed, our justice reporter. She's joining us on the phone, too. So, Christopher A. Ray, Paula, what can you tell us?
Well, he used to head up the criminal division at the Justice Department. Now, some people may not know that the Department of Justice, it has different pieces. You have one piece that looks at civil, one piece that looks at criminal, another solely devoted to civil rights, and another to national security. Now, the fact that he was in charge of the criminal division is significant. That's really the bread and butter of what the FBI is doing. I think that this news will be well received within the FBI. Someone who understands the Justice Department, how it works, someone with extensive experience in criminal matters. Now, since he worked for the Bush Justice Department, it appears he has been in private practice, but it does appear that he has at least some experience inside Maine Justice. A lot of folks were worried that the president could pick someone with no experience in this very complex, specific institution. So I think a lot of people inside the building, will be happy with his pick.
Yeah, certainly when Joe Lieberman's name was being floated around, people thought that would have been a very bad choice, precisely because of what you said. He was a lawmaker, and they wanted somebody with some familiarity with the justice system. You know, this is a big day on Capitol Hill, right, Paula? We've got the hearings into Russian meddling into the 2016 election. Today and tomorrow, some high-profile people will be testifying, not the least of which, former FBI Director James Comey. The timing is interesting.
It is interesting, and you know, some of us have been sort of speculating that this announcement was going to come, but Anne-Marie, we didn't expect it until tomorrow, if you're looking to create what we call counter-programming to Comey. So it is interesting timing. It will certainly distract from what will go on the Hill today. Many, as you noted, top law enforcement officials are going to be on the Hill. But right now, Anne-Marie, I mean, what the Justice Department needs, what the FBI needs, what the White House needs in its law enforcement is credibility. Right? This Justice Department so far, it's just been completely muddled in scandal. You know, the Attorney General, his first press conference, Anne-Marie, was to recuse himself from the biggest case in his portfolio because he lied. Mm-hmm. You then have Rod Rosenstein having to hand that case off to an independent counsel. You have the firing of Comey. His deputy is also sort of caught up in the Hillary Clinton email thing, so you can't appoint him. I mean, it's kind of a mess. Appointing someone to lead the FBI who brings these kind of credentials, this is very helpful for the White House.
Right, and sort of swirling around, there are a number of different reports by different publications indicating that the president was upset that Sessions recused himself, that possibly Sessions had actually offered to resign because his decision had upset the president so much, and that Dan Coats, who's testifying today, may have received some sort of pressure to influence the FBI on their investigation into this Russian meddling. These are all stories in the news right now.